As much as the astronauts practiced and prepared for the lunar landing, they had never done it before. Things don't always go as planned. The first lunar landing was no exception. Every step of the mission was meticulously planned. There was a huge crew on the ground monitoring every subsystem and system of the spacecraft. And if anyone had any doubt, they were capable of calling for an abort. Forget landing on the moon and just try to get home safely. Buzz Aldrin was the lunar module pilot. His job was to monitor all of the systems and to keep Neil Armstrong informed of how everything was going, whether there was anything anomalous or whether any changes had to be made. One of the most important things was eventually the lunar module had to pitch over from its sideways orientation to up and down. But it turned out that when it pitched over and the landing radar began to sense the moon's surface, the rendezvous radar was also sending some information to the computer. The computer got overloaded with more information than its memory could handle. All of a sudden, the computer sent out a 1202 alarm. Nobody at first was familiar with what the code meant except one man in mission control who had read all of the manuals developed at MIT, and he was able to recognize that the computer is getting too much information from things it didn't need information from, and it was going to ignore everything except the information it needed to land. They were running out of fuel, or at least the fuel gauges were telling them that fuel was running low. Neil, as he looked out the window, saw they were heading to an area with very large boulders, and he would need to fly a little bit further than they had intended. They were quickly running out of time. The people in mission control had to wait breathlessly until Armstrong indicated they had safely landed.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Roger, Tranquility. We copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.